Now let's blend it with the tissue. I just want to shade more here under this frontal bone because this area gets less light usually. It's bent inwards and that's why I want to shade it with a 2H to darken it a bit. And I press very lightly because I don't want to make sudden progress, but I'd rather go over again and again until it appears darker. Because if you overdo your shading, you have to brighten it up with an eraser and it's pretty difficult to make smooth again. So it's better to make slow progress than to rush. Now let's blend it with the tissue. Now let's blend it with a Q-tip. And now I just want to darken above this eyelid fold using a 4H, because here, as you can see, the dark shade jumps into the bright shade without that gradient transition in between, and I want to darken this area a bit more so that the section above the eyelid fold can appear more round. Okay, now let's move to the right side of the face, and here this whole side has to be quite brighter than the left side of the face. And I start with a 2H here over the temple. And now here is the question whether we want to draw the ear or just the hair. And actually I want to draw the ear to show you how to shade the ear. But probably I'm going to draw the hair over that. So if the hair is next to the face will be more shadowed than when the hair is behind the ear, for example. Then the more light is falling over the face or this side of the face if our light source is coming from the top right corner. And now let's just go downwards using a 2H all the time and circular motions. Just keep applying the same pressure, and then as you shade towards the nose, just release the pressure, because this will give the face that round shape. So about one third of this width between the nose and the ear we have to shade with the 2H.